Welcome back.
In the last video, we used the update power function to increase the character's power as we collected batteries. Now we're going to call the same function from the game mode to decrease the character's power over time. So we'll go ahead and switch back to Visual Studio. And we are in our character class right now, but let's go ahead and switch to the game mode header file. So we're going to create a decay rate. That's the rate by which our character's power will decrease over time. And we'll go ahead and make that protected just because that way we can only change it from the game mode or game mode inherited classes. And this will just be a float of decay rate. And that'll of course be the rate at which the character loses power. And the reason we're doing this in the game mode and not, say, the character or just another class is the game mode sets the rules of the game. And one of those rules is how fast the character loses power. For instance, say we had an easy version of this level and a hard version, we could have the game mode switch the decay rate from something lower to something higher and just have that all be handled in the rules of the game. And let's go ahead and give this some new properties, so we could change it in our blueprint if we'd like. We use new property, edit defaults only, which this is a little different than edit anywhere, which I've been using so far. For the game mode, it's not something you tend to place yourself and edit on the instance, and you really would just edit the defaults within the constructor, things like that. So that's why we're making this edit defaults only. And then blueprint read write so that we could say slow or increase the decay rates systematically in our blueprint. That's totally something that we would be okay with allowing. And again, this goes into the power category as a lot of these have in the past couple videos. So that should be everything we need to do here. Now, of course, we just go set a starting value for the decay rate. And we do that here in the constructor. So the base decay rate will be, let's start off with something slow so we can test this out, and put it at 0.01. Again, this is definitely one of those tweakable values that we've exposed so that gameplay designers could manipulate it easily within the editor. They don't have to necessarily come back and change it in the code. This is just a starting decay rate that we have so we can start testing. Now we're going to decrease the character's power on tick, and that's because we can then incorporate delta time and avoid the battery life decaying being frame rate dependent. So we're going to override tick, which is fairly straightforward to do. So we go back to our header file and we use virtual void tick, of course float delta time, which we're going to actually use, and then override. And again, very straightforward function override. Tick is something that's included on all actors, so we can go back to our game mode and start defining the function. So a battery collector game mode, this class's version. Delta time. And it's important that your signatures match when you're overriding a function. So we're going to go ahead and call the super. I don't know that there's anything in particular that we need to make sure it happens, but just in case, we'll do this. And that way we're not overriding whatever behavior from game mode this is already inheriting. Now we just need to include our gameplay static so that we can access the character and therefore work with the character from here. Let's see, so we include Kismet gameplay statics. And again, that's one of those libraries that has a lot of useful functions that you can use during the course of gameplay. And as you can see, we've already included the header file for a character, which is because the game mode is also where you set the character. That's the default pawn class to use for your game. So that's just already been done for us in the template code. So after we've called the parent behavior with that super call, we're going to access our current character. So we're going to do that with a battery collector character, pointer to my character. And we're just going to go ahead and put the cast in this line too. So I'm going to try to cast to battery collector character. And that's, you know, just in case you're using a default pawn or something, we need to make sure that this is our type of character so we can access the power functions. And so this is where we're going to use that uGameplayStatics function of getPlayerPawn. And then if that cast is successful, you definitely want to make sure you have this. Then my character. Then, once you're sure that you're actually working with a battery collector character, and you can then see my character update power. And then we can set, take into account delta time, like I said, in case frame rate changes, our decay rate. And then we're going to get that initial power off of your character as well. So my character call get initial power. And that's a function call, so you have to close or add the brackets there. Again, because update power is taking in the amount that our power will change by, your character's power will decrease by some fraction of the initial power. However, I'm not thinking about it, I only want to do this if my character's power is positive. I don't want to keep subtracting power if it's less than zero. So let's go ahead and add a really quick call to see if my character, and then use get power. Or get current power. If that is greater than zero, then do this line where I change the power. And we'll just add a couple comments really quick, just so when we come back to this, we know what it was that this code does. So check that we are using the battery collector character. And then if the character's power is positive, decrease the character's power using the decay rate. So again, we're taking into account the time that has passed since the last tick, the decay rate variable that we set, and then our character's initial power. So based on however much power the character had initially, we'll decay it by some small amount every frame. And at this point, we can compile and I'll show you how this looks on the character's power level. So go ahead and hit compile. And actually in the video after this, we're going to start setting up some visual effects, so it'll be easier to tell the power level is increasing or decreasing without having to look in the details panel and keep an eye on it that way. Okay, we finished compiling, and we'll go ahead and hit play. And I'll scroll down and select the third person character, and you can see that power is decreasing automatically on every frame, just a little bit. But then if I go collect batteries, it will increase by the amount of the power selected by the, or provided by the batteries. So now we've got both forces on the character's power, one trying to increase it, one trying to decrease it, and we can start working on some of the visuals. Thanks.